Hello folks, Robert from Marine Depot here, and I have something a little different for you guys in this video. The Marine Lab over at Concordia University in Irvine invited us to tag along with them on a recent outing to our local tide pools.
This was no regular trip to the beach either, because we are accompanied by an entire class of elementary school students as well.
Concordia University is working to help expose kids to marine biology and the importance of preserving our natural environment.
So my name is Sean Benyami. I'm a biology professor. I'm the department chair in the biology department, and I'm the director of the Concordia University Marine Lab. I've been interested in marine biology my whole life, from when I was a kid and my mom used to take me out to the tide pools. And I've been studying it since I was an undergraduate, officially, studying it. And through graduate school, undergraduate at UC Santa Barbara, and then a PhD at University of Miami, Florida, and then out here to the back to the West Coast. So today at Corona Del Mar, we brought a group of second graders out here. It was about 60 second graders who were learning about the intertidal habitats, the different zones in the intertidal habitats, and how the animals that live in those zones differ and how they have adaptations to survive the conditions in certain zones. So we did a workshop with them last week where they had mobile touch tanks at their school that we bring to their school. They saw the animals, and then we taught them how to take quadrat surveys and collect data on species diversity and species richness. And they practiced that in their multipurpose room. And then now this week they came out here and they used those same quadrats and they collect real data in the real world, which they'll go back to their school and put together some graphs and compare the upper and lower intertidal zones. So the objective of the Marine Lab has three key priorities. It's education, outreach, and research. So our education is both on our campus with our students. We're a resource for our students in our classes. We have an outreach program. This mobile outreach program is sponsored by the California Coastal Commission grant right now, and we bring mobile touch tanks into schools and to public events to teach and increase ocean literacy. And then the third sort of prong is research. So we actively participate in research, both field work and in our marine lab, both student and faculty research. And a lot of those projects are in collaboration with other universities.
For me, the coolest thing was to watch all of the kids interact and ask questions about the wildlife found in the tide pools. Sean and his group of undergrad students taught the kids how to collect and apply field data. Specifically, they looked at the biodiversity by counting and recording the different species found in small sample sections of the upper and middle tidal zones. Of course, these animals are a little different than what you're going to find in a tropical reef tank because our oceans are a little colder and considered a temperate environment. Growing up in Southern California, visiting the tide pools is sort of like a rite of passage. It was very nostalgic for me to watch the kids run around and get so excited about all of the amazing animals that can be found right here in our backyard. Be sure to stick around because we have some really interesting projects in store with the Concordia University Marine Lab, and we'll be posting videos all summer long right here on YouTube. Now we're still brainstorming, but I can say that a tour of the Marine Lab and building an aquarium for research are both on the video schedule. I appreciate all of you for watching, and until next time,
take care and happy reef keeping!